Christian Ak here for Insight Media's Display Week 24 Porotech booth. Let's take a look at their micro LEDs. First thing I want to highlight here is an innovation in their DPT, that's dynamic pixel tuning. So dynamic pixel tuning is a technology that Porotech developed where a single LED device can take on any of these colors. It's just a matter of current and waveform. So you can choose anything between the blue, the green, or the red, depending on what you choose and how you drive it. So that's really powerful because it could it gives you all kinds of flexibility in how you design your micro LED. You could have higher density or bigger devices with lower resolution, lots of options. So what they're talking about here is adaptive DPT. So the idea here is if you have a AR glasses on and you're looking at a specific environment, your outdoor environment or whatever environment you're in can change. And so if you're having, especially you have a monochrome display, if it's monochrome green and you're looking at, trying to look at contents in a green background, the contrast is going to be hard to see, right? So there are ways to solve that. You can use a camera to look at that background. You do image processing to change the signal. So it would, instead of being green, it might go to some other color. But that takes power and signal processing. With the DPT, it's different, and that's what this demo shows. It has a little camera sensor here that's looking at the scene that's playing on the screen here. It senses that background, but instead of doing image processing, it can now actually just change the waveform to change the color of that DPT pixel. So if you start with a DPT array here, I'm trying to get into the field of view here. I don't think the camera's going to be able to do this. But I can tell you, having demoed it, that the color of does change. You can see it go from red to green to orange, depending on the background. So that's actually pretty cool. Let's also talk about some of the other products that they've got here. New for the show is this 0.12 device. It is a green only right now. With these specifications, 640 by 480, 3.75 pitch, and 3 micron device. This is the smallest one they're making right now, so the idea is to prove it out on green, then they'll move on to red, blue, and DPT. They also have a prototype. This is also a prototype of a color-converted device. I'm not sure of the state. They weren't too clear on the size, but it is a it's a full HD resolution, a 3x8 micron device, and this obviously color converted with quantum dots and photolithography, still in development, obviously. And then they just have some demos here of this. This is that that new 0.12 device in integrated into a waveguide. They're also showing these 0.26 inch devices that they've had for a couple of years. And then there is a new device also. This is a 0.26 inch 0.61 inch device. And red, green, and blue versions of this are available as well. So what they've done here is put this together as a pico projector demo. So they bought a backplane from a supplier, and they processed red, green, and blue wafers in this size. Those are then cut up and packaged and put into an X-cube combination. And then this projector demo is shown here. They don't have the luminance on this guy. It's not too bad. Pico projectors are pretty dim to begin with. So this could be maybe a viable product. It's XGA resolution, and then that same device but a green-only version was put into this AR HUD demonstrator over here. This is, it's not really an AR HUD because it's just limited field of view. I mean, there's no real specs on what this thing is as a HUD. They just put this kind of arbitrary configuration here to show it could be put into a HUD application. So they're really putting this together to see if they can attract customers for a device like this. And obviously a panel that's bigger like this 0.61 allows you to use bigger micro LEDs, allows you to get to higher luminance. So this is their full workflow. They basically buy the they process the LED epi wafers themselves because they have this special poro layer to allow them to create the DPT pixel, pixelated, and then they, because this is all done on silicon, then they mate that in a wafer bonding process to the driving circuit, the CMOS driving circuit, and pixelate those and separate them. So this is one of the key ecosystems that's starting to develop. So it's Porotech and the Foxconn group trying to develop a more mass-produced ecosystem for micro LEDs. And then you've also kind of got the AUO Play Nitride group also trying to develop their own ecosystem. So that's pretty much the story here at Display Week in the Porotech booth, Chris Chinnock for Insight Media.